अहिंसा महाव्रत, मरा महाव्रत एवरीबडी नोस, ओके, देन ऑल फाइव ऑल एक इंद्रिय बेइंद्रिय त्रिइंद्रिय चौरेन्द्रिय पंचेन्द्रिय, वी कैन नॉट डू एनी वायलेंस एज अ साधु, कीप दैट थिंग इन माइंड, एज अ साधु वी हैव टू ऑल फाइव सोल्स, वन इंद्रिय सोल, टू थ्री फोर फाइव शुड नॉट बी गिवन नो एनी वायलेंस फ्रॉम अस, ओके, दैट्स वाई साधु गो फॉर गोचरी, अरे दैट गोचरी ऑल्सो इट इज सेड, इफ यू ईट फूड मेक श्योर इट इज नॉट मेंट फॉर यू, वॉट एवर श्रावक हैज मेड टेक वेरी लिटल दैट दे डोंट हैव टू रीकुक एनी फूड, ओके, एंड you are not a burden to any sravaks, that is the sadhu dharma. I bet you not more than few percentage people will know what is the sravak dharma anuvrat, and I'm going to tell you that the sravak anuvrat, ahimsa anuvrat of sravak dharma, it is and that's before even I say that definition, I wanted to explain you something, that Sravak Dharma, it is a very practical definition. Jainism, Bhagwan Mahavira said that any soul trusts you. Okay, any soul means only the trust jiv. Shravak should not hurt any trust jiv, means halta chalta, movable living beings. Okay, they should not hurt. And what kind of the one? The trust soul, which are nirapradhi. Okay, nirapradhi means if somebody comes in my home and robs me, that is not a nirapradhi. Okay, I can protect myself, I don't become aggressive to hurt anybody, but at the same time Sravak Dharma indicates clearly you got to protect yourself, protect the family, and protect everything. It is not part of your vow even, okay? And only trust jiv means is a from two sense to five senses, okay, that is called the trust. We are not allowed to hurt trust jiv. We are not allowed to hurt any nirapradhi. And third, knowingly, this is the third one. And knowingly, you should not hurt, trust you. Knowingly means I am walking with somebody. Okay, I am very careful. I don't hurt anybody, any insects or anything. But the situation, when I am Sravak going through it, sometimes it could happen, I'm putting a foot on the ground and maybe insects comes, well, where I don't have any intention to hurt him, okay? In a true sense, I'm trying to tell you, okay? Then it is not also part of your vrat. So nirapradhi is the one thing. Okay, somebody hurts. And second thing, unknowingly. That means knowingly I would not hurt. So now you look at it, my anuvrat vakya. I will not hurt knowingly and nirapradhi any trust jiv. Nothing is said about ekindriya. Because the life can only exist. This is, I'm trying to just giving you the agam definition of anuvrat. Okay, and that's what Bhagwan Mahavir gave that vrat to Anand Sravak. Go and look at it, the seventh agam, Upashak Dashan. All right, and all the vrats are defined into it. We have a Hindi, Gujarati version of that seven and Hindi version of that seven agam. Okay, not every agam is been translated into English. Whatever it is, I've already put it on the e-library. Okay, so that way you can study yourself, not because I am saying it, otherwise I become one of them, one of the other, you know, scholars. They come and talk about that. Okay, so what I'm trying to explain you, that in Ahimsa Anuvrat, there is no mention about Kanmur. There is nothing mentioned about Ratri Bhojan. For Shravak, okay? For monks, yes, they are all mentioned. And I have asked several scholars. Nobody has given me any answer. Okay, if it is not in the Ahimsa Anuvrat, by adding something into it, which is good thing, I'm not disputing that. But first you got to understand what is your limitation. And because of that, now nobody takes the vows. Because you got to boil the water, which has ekindriya souls, you are killing everyone. You cook the food, you are killing all ekindriya souls. Now in ekindriya, we are saying, oh, this is a vanaspatika pratyek, which is okay, sadharan not allowed. Now, do you really understand what are you talking about it in the fundamentals of Jainism? If you want to read, there is one very courageous acharya has written, Nyaya Vijayji. Nyaya Vijayji has written a book, Jain Darshan. And in one book, there are six different parts. And one of the best book I would ever say, when I was Mahavir Jain Vidyalaya, that was a textbook. In the evening, they were teaching Jainism in that one. All right, and I explained to them, okay, why are we not practicing according to this one? And my teacher, what he was, this is very important when I say, it is like if you knew Kumarpal Desai, his uncle, Ratibhi Dipchand Desai, he was the Pachala teachers in Mahavir Jain Vidyalaya. And I used to argue even at that time when I was in the college. Okay, and this is amazing that the whole society was against Nyaya Vijayji that time. No, he was in Patan. And if you study in depth, then you realize what is the Jain Shravak Dharma. And we need to understand and practice it. Our children will practice properly. And they will practice it properly. Otherwise, today the Jain Dharma is such, we are imposing Sradhu Dharmas, certain achars, which is not practical in this country. You follow what I'm trying to tell you? And if you go into every anuvrat, you will realize it. What we are selective. certain things we don't bother about it, okay, which should be bothered, all right, and certain things we don't bother it, and certain things we bother it, okay. These are a very major, major problem, but we have it at the Shravak Dharma. Okay, look at it, veganism. Can you believe every cow is being killed and slaughtered? And we don't have any problem, no, putting the milk on the murti, all right, or eating all that one. That is absolutely not allowed. From Trasjeev, we are doing these things. And then now the world of knowledge is at your fingertips. That's my point to you. We can discuss it, but it is not going to be like 1 hour a week. You're going to learn significant things, okay? You got to put at least 1 or 2 hours every day to study Jainism. And that's what I did myself. Very few people would say, I have read all 45 items. I may not, I have understood it. I don't remember everything, okay? That's the key thing in the mind, but I wanted to find the source of the things, what I do, okay? So I hope I'm a little bit hard on this one, but otherwise it is very extremely difficult to practice Jainism the way we came with the Indian culture, bring it over here, and whatever we were practicing, that's what, you know, we are considering that is the Jain Dharma. And that's why if you look into it, how many children really practice it? It is the same kind of the complaint every parents have it. But very few parents are ready to understand Jainism. We started a blog. We got this 10, 11 committee members in the blog, and they are taking one question. These are all contemporary questions of this country. And we try to provide the answers, okay? And these are the things, but it is not going to be easy. 1 hour a week or 1.5 hours a week is going to get, you study about it. You got to put the effort and practice it. Then and then the survive. Otherwise, Jainism is not going to survive in this country. Believe me or not, okay? Because 70% of Jain children are marrying Americans. And a very good statistics, I'm telling you, it may be more. How are we going to survive? We are not in a majority like Hindu religion, that they can still survive because the sheer number is there. Jains are not that many in that sense. Any question, any other one, I'm trying to